the Rolling Spider, it's quite advanced for its $100 price point, but the main difference between a good drone versus a great drone is its features, controls, and durability, and luckily, the Parrot has it all. There are a lot of manufacturers making drones nowadays, but the Rolling Spider really stood out to me. Concerning features, it has a camera, intuitive software, and luckily, this is the simplest way to fly a drone yet. You can control it with your smartphone or tablet, but it seems like Parrot favors the iOS device a little bit more, considering that the Android app seems a little bit sluggish and only done half right. But once you get it set up and the controls coupled with the built-in ultrasonic sensor, it keeps the flight experience simple and easy. In fact, so easy that Parrot really wants the Rolling Spider to be the ultimate indoor drone, and they express that by providing additional hardware and accessories to make that happen. It comes with a pair of wheels and an ultrasonic sensor that helps it detect its distance from the ground, and the software is designed to make flight stable. When you hit the dedicated takeoff button, the drone flies up and is completely still as long as wind, or in this case, crooked propellers aren't putting it off axis, and the ultrasonic sensor knows exactly how far away it is from objects under it, and these things combined will usually result in less crashes unless overtaken by operator error. Speaking of operating error, the drone is controlled by either your smartphone or tablet paired with the FreeFlight Free app. The app looks okay, is designed okay, but it does have some bugs that make flying a nuisance. Primarily that it doesn't have the same experience as a controller, but surprisingly the FreeFlight 3 app is good enough for whatever you want to do. You can move in pretty much any direction with any pair of controls that you would like. You can use the gyroscope on your device or go with the classic joystick layout, and the best part is that there's a dedicated gesture to do more advanced things like flip 360 degrees both forward and backwards. The FreeFlight 3 app also allows you to do things like control the camera. It's facing downward, so you'll only be able to get bird's eye view angles, but I think that's good enough for a sub-$100 drone. The camera can take photos and record videos that are sub-HD but aren't absolutely horrible. The Rolling Spider excels at other things too, its build being one of them. It's made entirely out of plastic and has as little moving parts as possible, and it feels really sturdy for a drone of its price. In fact, it feels as if they took a single block of plastic and shaved away the pieces until it looked complete instead of just taking plastic bits and sticking them together. But there were some instances where I noticed areas that definitely needed improvement, like the rubber feet that fall off, but other than that, this is a pretty solid little drone, and if you're looking for leisure, this is definitely the place to start.